Problem 4. Consider sequences A1, A2, A3, and so on, of positive real numbers with A1 equal to 1, and such that AN plus 1 plus AN is equal to AN plus 1 minus AN all squared for each positive integer N. How many possible values can A2017 take? So when I first saw this problem, I couldn't think of anything to do other than to try to work out what the first few values were. Obviously, the problem tells us that A1 is 1, so we can try to work out what A2 is. And we can do that by substituting N equals 1 into this equation. So we get A2 plus A1 equals A2 minus A1 all squared. But we know that A1 is 1, so we can substitute that in. Now, this is an equation we can solve by multiplying out the right-hand side. Yeah. A2 squared minus 2A2 plus 1. Now, if we gather terms all on one side, we get A2 squared minus 3A2 equals 0. That's a quadratic equation in A2, so either by solving it using the quadratic formula or factorising it, we can see that A2 has to be 0 or 3. But the problem tells us that the numbers AN have to be positive, so A2 can't be 0, so it's got to be 3. So we've got A2 is 3. Now we've successfully worked out A2, let's try to work out A3. We'll do that similarly by substituting N equals 2 into here. So we get A3 plus 3 equals A3 minus 3 all squared. And again, that's a quadratic in A3, or it would be if we multiplied it out. And we can quickly check that it's got solutions A3 equals 1, or A3 equals 6. Now, this equation says that each term only depends on the term before it, and we know what happens after we've got a term 1, because A1 was 1. So in order to explore this more, I'm going to see what happens if A3 is 6, and solve another quadratic. So if A3 is equal to 6, then A4 plus 6 is equal to A4 minus 6 all squared. And again, that's a quadratic equation. And if we solve it, we find that A4 is either 3 or 10. It's now worth summarising what we know. So we started with 1, and the next term after 1 could be 3, or it could have been 0, except that wasn't allowed. After a 3, the next term could either be 1 or 6. And after a 6, the next term could either be 3 or 10. After we get here, or perhaps after we compute a few more terms, it looks like what we're doing is moving around the triangular numbers. So this is the number 1, this is 1 plus 2, this is 1 plus 2 plus 3, and this is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So it looks like from each term, we move to the next term, which is either the triangular number afterwards or the triangular number before. Okay, let's try to prove that. If you know the formula 1/2 n n plus 1 for the triangular numbers, you can prove it algebraically. But we're going to try to find a geometric proof. Here's a square array of dots. Now, suppose I divide it into two triangles like this. There's one. And there's the other. Both of these triangles have triangular numbers of dots in. This one here has got 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. And this one here has got 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6. These are consecutive triangular numbers. So if we take an n by n grid, we can divide it into two consecutive triangular numbers. Now let's look at the difference between these two triangles. This triangle here has as many dots as this triangle here, plus extra dots corresponding to the ones down the diagonal. But of course there are seven dots down the diagonal, and seven is also the side length of the square. So that means that if we take the difference between the numbers of dots in the two triangles, we get the side length of the square, and of course the side length squared is the number of dots in the square, which we decided earlier was the sum of the numbers of dots in the two triangles. So that says that if an and an plus 1 happen to be two consecutive triangular numbers, then this formula will be true. And notice it's true no matter which way round they are. So if an plus 1 is the next triangular number up from an, this will be true. But it's also true if an plus 1 is the next triangular number down, because it's symmetric in the two. If we swap the two around, we get the same here, and we also get the same here, because if we negate something and square it, we get the same result as if we just square it. Now, what does this tell us? If we know what an is, then this is a quadratic equation for an plus 1. Quadratic equations have at most two roots. So if we multiplied this equation out, found a quadratic equation, it could have at most two solutions. But what we've said means that we know what those two solutions are if we know that an is a triangular number. An plus 1 could be the next triangular number up or the next triangular number down. Could be either of those, and because it's a quadratic equation, it can't be anything else. Now let's look at what this tells us. I'm going to write Tn for the nth triangular number. Now the question tells us that A1 is 1, in other words that it's T1, the first triangular number. And then we worked out that A2 had to be T2, which is 3, the second triangular number. Then after that, A3 can be the next triangular number up or the next triangular number down. So A3 can either be T1 or T3. Now A4 can be the next triangular number up or down from any of these, except that we can't go below T1. So A4 can be T2 or T4. That's the next triangular number up from T1 or up or down from T3. Similarly, A5 can be the next up or down from any of those, so it can be T1 or T3 or T5. This pattern, of course, continues. When we get to A2017, we're going to find that that can be T1 or T3 or T5, or in fact any odd numbered T up to T2017. So how many possibilities are there? Well, the number of different possibilities for A2017 is the same as the number of odd numbers up to 2017, and there are 1,009 of them. So the answer is 1,009. There are 1,009 possibilities for what A2017 can be.